Express lets us create a simple server in only a few lines of code, getting to Hello World quickly. The basic concepts of routing, handlers, and middleware that we'll work with are the foundation of any server you'll build with Express. In this tutorial, we'll create and run a simple Express server. We'll create routes and handlers for the server, and also write a custom middleware to log the requests the server receives. To get started, let's open a terminal and create a directory for the project. Then we'll enter the directory with cd hello express. Let's initialize a package.json so we can install some dependencies. Now we'll install Express with npm I express. We'll also install a package called Nodemon as a dev dependency to restart the server during development. Finally, we'll create an index.js file as the main entry point to the project. Now let's open our project in our text editor. We're going to create a dev script that uses Nodemon to run the index.js file. So let's open our package.json file and add an entry to the scripts field. Once we've done that, we can run the dev script with npm run dev. Our index.js file is empty, so Nodemon will run it and then just wait for any updates. You can stop Nodemon at any time by selecting the terminal window and hitting Ctrl-C. Let's open index.js and create our Express app. We'll require Express, define a port variable, create an instance of Express called app, and then we'll start our server. After saving the file, you should see Nodemon restarted and logged our message that the server is now running. We need to add a route to our server before we can interact with it. Let's add a route that listens to GET requests at the path /test. We'll send back a JSON response with OK true. Save the file and then open a browser to localhost 3000/test. You should see a JSON object with OK true if everything is working properly. Let's create another route that accepts a dynamic parameter as part of the path. We'll use the path /greet and add a parameter called name. Parameters are added to a path by prefixing a key for the parameter with a colon. Then, in the response handler, we can access the parameter at rec.params and then the parameter's key. We'll send back a JSON response with a greeting that uses the parameter from the path. Now we save the file and open a browser to localhost 3000/greet/john. You'll see a JSON response greeting whatever value you used as the name parameter. Using parameters and paths is a really useful way to pass in dynamic values to a request, like an ID or something else you want to use in your code. Next, we'll create a simple middleware to log requests the server receives. To create the middleware, we'll define a function that takes the parameters rec, res, and next. We're going to log out the Unix timestamp of when the request was received, the request method, and the path the request was sent to. Now we'll register the middleware to run for every request by passing it to app.use. If you think I've missed something, you're right, but hang on for just a sec. After registering the middleware, let's open the browser back to our /test route. If you look at the browser window, the page is still loading, and we haven't navigated away from the greeting route. We haven't gotten our OK true response. But if you look at the terminal window, you'll see that our request has been logged to the console. What's happening is our request is stuck. It hasn't actually completed. That's because we forgot an important part of middleware. We never called the next function. Without calling next, the request never moves past this middleware. It can never make it to our route handler, and so a response is never sent. The request will just hang there. This is such a common bug, I wanted to make sure I showed you it. Always be sure to call next when a middleware has succeeded. To fix it, all we need to do is call next in the middleware, save the page, and then reload the browser page. Now that we're calling next, the request can complete successfully, and we're able to see our response. That's all there is to creating a basic Express server. It comes down to creating routes and handlers and using middleware. To recap, in this tutorial, we created and ran a simple Express server. We created two route handlers, with one taking a dynamic parameter as part of the URL path, which we then used in our response handler. And we also created a custom middleware to log requests sent to the server.